The Iron Silk Road, a large-scale project to connect the Korean Peninsula to the Eurasian continent through railroads. What will the Iron Silk Road mean after the peace process on the Korean Peninsula? Today, we invite famous experts in the Korean culture industry. Pansori master Song Sun-sup is the only male singer among five Pansori human cultural assets and a respectful legend. Master Kim Jong-hung is a performer of the intangible cultural property number 69, Hahwe Pyeolsingut Talnori. Master Park Geun-young, he is the drummer of Daejeon intangible cultural property number 17, Pansori accompaniment. Creator Lee So-yeon, she is a famous traveler YouTuber who uploaded videos of her 100 days of trip around the world. Chinese creator Edie Chen, she is one of the most famous Chinese travel and beauty creators. Webtoon artist Kim Kang-sup, aka Dodo, with his beautiful watercolor techniques and well-created stories. Illustrator Lee Soo-kyung, she communicates with people by drawing emotions that people feel in their daily lives. Animation director Im Chang-mook, he introduces history in the most modern way by producing animated films of history and computer graphics. Songwriter Kim Eun-woo, he worked with many famous Korean singers. The 21st century Iron Silk Road exploration starts now, with eight members representing the Korean culture. Iron Silk Road, the road where the clock stopped for the past century because of the division between South and North Korea. With the hopes of peace and prosperity, our first destination is Xi'an in China. Emperor Jin Shi Huang built the foundation in Xi'an to unite China. Xi'an was the capital that led Chinese history and the center of the ancient Silk Road. The wealth and glory of the past can be seen in the streets of the city. About 5 kilometers from the west gate of Xi'an city wall, there is Kaewon Gate. A sculpture depicting a caravan where people are loading their stuff on camels and leaving for the Silk Road is catching people's eyes. The sculpture is a symbol that Xi'an was the starting place of the ancient Silk Road. The Silk Road was a long trade route connecting the east and west. Chinese silk was delivered to the western Mediterranean Sea through the Silk Road. During the Roman Empire, people wore Chinese silk to show off their wealth. Not only silk, but pottery, frankincense, copper, gold, and many other goods crossed the continent. Xi'an was the center of the Silk Road, where the Eastern and Western culture gathered. Xi'an, a historic city of the Silk Road. Our first place to visit is the Seonyusa Temple. The Buddhist monk He Cho, who was from the unified Silla, lived here. He wrote the Wangho Chanchukukjan, a travelogue that introduced the maritime and overland Silk Road to the world. He described his journey to the Xi'an, which was the central city of the Silk Road. He left a precious cultural heritage, which was the only book containing information about the political and cultural customs of the 8th century India and Central Asia. Emperor Taejong of Tang asked He Cho to hold rain-making ceremonies in this temple. The temple has a monument to commemorate Buddhist monk He Cho.
정말 그 중국 멀리 중국에 그 해초 스님이 다녀간 머무셨던 곳에서 이런 기원제를 드린다는 것은 정말 저로서도 앞으로 한반도의 평화와 실크로드가 다시 한번 연결돼서 동북아로 나갈 수 있는 그런 큰 기점이 되었으면 좋겠습니다.
선유사, the temple where Buddhist monk He Cho lived, who pioneered the Silk Road about 1,200 years ago.
대한민국과 좋은 연결을 통해서 실크로드로 연결될 수 있는 길을 최소.
Praying with the hope that one day the disconnected road due to division will be once again connected and lead us to the path of peace and prosperity through the Iron Silk Road. 네. It is not just Master Kim Jong-hung who is deeply moved to visit the temple where Buddhist monk He Cho lived. Korea's most famous Pansori master and human cultural asset Song Sun-sup is giving an improvised performance in front of the temple, saying that a song came up to his mind. Bindang Taryong, or the Silk Song, is a song from Hungbuga, one of the five stories of the Korean pansori storytelling. It is a song dedicated to Haecho, who explored the Silk Road a long time ago. And glorious culture that bloomed with the Silk Road gave rise to Xi'an, the capital for 1,000 years. The second place to visit in Xi'an is where many artists found inspiration and sang about. Huaqing Pool is a hot spring in Mount Li in Xi'an. It is known as where Yang Guibi, the most beautiful woman in China, enjoyed taking a bath. The most dramatic love story of Emperor Hyunjong and Yang Guibi. Even hundreds of years later, Huaqing Pool is crowded with people, fascinated by their love story. Just like weaving silk with warp and weft, the city of the Silk Road, Xi'an, intertwined Eastern and Western philosophy, culture, and people. What experiences did the exploration team have in this city?
感觉特别好，因为可能之前我对中国的传统文化没有那么了解。那这次爱尔兰电视台还有爱尔兰电视台代表韩国的非常优秀、非常著名的一些文化大师们来到中国，表演了很多的韩国传统的节目，比如说板索里的那个唱段，是这么说吧？是要唱段吗？
제가 생각해보면 한 땅에 같이 있는 나라인데 네, 일단 단절되어 있다는 느낌이 강하고 실제로도 단절되어 있고 이렇게 왠지 다른 세상 같은데 그렇게 연결되어 있다면 진짜 가깝게 느껴질 것 같아요.
The first day ends for the 21st century Iron Silk Road exploration team. From the center of the ancient Silk Road, Xi'an is taking a second leap as the starting point of the Belt and Road Initiative, a modern version of the ancient Silk Road. Xi'an dramatically expanded its transportation network as the Chinese government designated the city to be the hub for the Belt and Road Initiative that crosses the Eurasian continent. With Xi'an's train station in the center, railroads spread to 17 cities, including Beijing, Shanghai, Chengzhou, Taiyuan, Wuhan, Hangzhou, and Guangzhou. If people traveled on camels in the past, now they travel by trains. The 21st Century Iron Silk Road Exploration Team is on a train that crosses the continent. The train speed is 350 kilometers per hour, but still, they have to take the train for 10 hours.
아침에 출발해서 아마 3시간째 달리고 있는데 정말 넓은 내륙이라는 게 실감이 납니다. 실크로드를 통해서 우리가 앞으로 철도가 아시아를 통해서 유럽까지 갈 수 있는 그런 길을 걸어간다는 게 참 의미가 참 좋네요.
Traveling the same ancient Silk Road that people used to travel in the past, songwriter Kim Eun-woo is expressing his emotions through music. The 21st Century Iron Silk Road Exploration Team visited Guangdong Court in Lushangku District, Dalian, Liaoning Province. After the Russian-Japanese War in 1905, the building was used as a high court and local court by Japan, who occupied Dalian until 1945, when Japan surrendered. Many Korean and Chinese patriotic martyrs who participated in the war of resistance against Japanese aggression were brought to trial here. During the past century, the Silk Road turned from a road where the Eastern and Western exchanged culture to a road of war where the plunder and invasion happened. During World War II, many Korean and Chinese people suffered from Japan's invasion. In the middle of the Silk Road, there is the Taklamakan Desert, meaning once you get in, you'll never get out. During those days, it was hard to find justice even in the court that discusses the law. It was like being in a desert, a hopeless place without a drop of water. On the second floor, there is a memorial space for independence fighter An Jung-gun. He was on trial here.
우리 한민족으로서 우리 독립을 위해서 싸우시다 돌아가신 그 열사님의 그 추모를 하는 마당에서 정말 감회가 스럽습니다.
어머니가 그만한 훌륭한 분이기 때문에 아들도 그렇게 훌륭한 사람 낳았어요.
No matter how much time has passed, the noble spirit remains. During the past century, good people sacrificed their lives for their country. We are standing here today thanks to their sacrifice and dedication. Two young members of the team, songwriter Kim Eun-woo and travel creator Lee So-yeon, are burning incense sticks. What does this place mean to them, who didn't experience the war?
이 역사적인 현장에 와서 그 감정이 뭐랄까 그런 무거운 기운이 여기까지 느껴지는 것 같아요. 그러다 보니까 좀 가슴이 먹먹하고 많은 생각이 들게 하는 것 같습니다.
2019년 지금이 있기까지 이제 만들어진 수많은 역사 영웅분들이 계신데 감사하다는 말씀 드리고 싶습니다.
After six trials, independence fighter An Jung-gun was sentenced to death in this court. In 1909, An shot Ito Hirobumi three times without a miss at the Harbin Railway Station. After the shooting, he didn't run away. He threw the gun and got caught. His purpose was not just about the assassination. It was an action to expose the real face of the Japanese imperialism to the world. An called Japan the main culprit who stole Korea's independent sovereignty and the peacebreaker of East Asia. Before his execution, he left a will asking to bury his remains in his country when Korea reclaims its national sovereignty. But Japan did not deliver his remains to his family. Korea still owes him. The next place the 21st Century Iron Silk Road Exploration Team visited is the Amrok River Bridge in Dangdong, Liaoning Province, China. It connects the cities of Shin-uiju of North Pyongan and Dangdong of Liaoning. It is a gateway that connects the Korean Peninsula and Northeast China. Two bridges were constructed in 1911 and 1943. The older bridge on the downstream was destroyed during the Korean War, leaving only half of the bridge flanked on the Chinese side. The Amrok River Bridge shows the disconnection of the past half century.
이 암록강 단교는 6.25 전쟁 당시에 끊어진 우리나라의 가슴 아픈 역사가 담긴 흔적이다. 우리나라도 언젠가는 기차를 타고 북한 신의주를 건너 중국, 유라시아까지 여행할 수 있는 날이 다가오기를 바라본다.
The Broken Bridge. The Korean Peninsula's interrupted dream of the Silk Road. But we have the strength to face the past and move forward. We are proud of our history of overcoming our hardship. We have hope for the future. Illustrator Yi Soo-kyung drew her emotions to post on social media. North Korea. A country that is close to, but at the same time, far from South Korea. As the last divided country, the time has stopped between the iron fence that is dividing the two Koreas. But after the 2018 Pyeongchang Winter Olympics, the inter-Korean summit was at last held in Panmunjom. Since then, the Korean Peninsula has been moving closer and closer to peace and prosperity. To peace and prosperity. With our desire to connect the broken bridge, the Iron Silk Road is new hope for the Korean Peninsula. The Iron Silk Road is becoming our future. No matter how cold the winter is, spring will come. Recently, there is a busy place as the frozen relationship between the two Koreas is melting. Inco Pilot Free Trade Zone. Liaoning Free Trade Zone is a national-scale free trade zone that is located near Dandong, a city on the border with Shinuiju in North Korea. It has an importation geopolitical location for linking Korea's new northern policy and China's Belt and Road Initiative. After the settlement of the Korean Peninsula's peace process, it will connect Korea, China, Russia, and Mongolia by land, sea, and air. It is expected to rise as an important hub of logistics in Northeast Asia. As the inter-Korean dialogue resumed, local residents are also having a high expectation that the Iron Silk Road will be successful. The 21st Century Iron Silk Road Exploration Team is also receiving great attention as they are the first Korean team to visit Inkao. In Inkao Pilot Free Trade Zone, economists and trade experts from Korea and China are discussing the current situation and the future of the Silk Road trade. Pansori master Song Sun-sup is giving a special performance. The song is Jebi Nojungi from Hungbuga. The song is about a swallow flying from China with a ground seed to repay Hungbu's kindness. Master Song chose this song because the route that the swallow flew is similar to the route of the Iron Silk Road. The Korea-China Economic and Cultural Exchange Meeting held in Inkao is over. The 21st Century Iron Silk Road Exploration Team also finished its journey. The Iron Silk Road, the Korean Peninsula's wish in the 21st century. It will take great effort to open the road, like weaving silk with warp and weft. Cities and countries need to communicate and understand one another. To make sure that the Iron Silk Road becomes a road of peace and prosperity, not a road of war, Korea, China, and other countries where railroads cross need to work together. Then we will have a future more smooth and shiny than any other silk.